Being the astute and smart chaplain that I was, I thought, she knew that she had latched on to something that was important. And somehow in this conversation, things began to shift. I don't know when that happened. But it happened. It's interesting to me how you and I assign end times to various things. Medical diagnoses in our lives, we see and hear those through our particular eyes and ears. And to us, they mean something. Be they ours or someone else's, we hear them. And when someone says, well, I've been diagnosed with such and such, we hear in that revelation, oh, it's going to be like Aunt Susan. End times are things that you and I encounter on various bases. And we encounter them in our scriptures. A few weeks ago, we read what's called the Little Apocalypse in Mark, which is the mirror text of what we read today in Luke. And that whole setup is different. For Luke, or for Mark, his emphasis on this end time of Jesus coming back is, when is it going to happen? When is it going to happen? It's going to happen sometime soon. Well, Luke writes a little differently. He's writing 10 years after Mark, and he's writing about 50 years after Jesus has died, and he's going to begin this idea that Jesus is coming back for this big apocalyptic event, but it hasn't happened. Maybe we need to think about something different. Maybe we need to think about how we're going to live until the event happens. You and I may get a day later and take the newspaper and put it here. Mark's gospel and put it here. Luke's gospel and put it here. You go, well, this one matches this one. This one matches this one. The end is coming. But remember, been that way for the last 2,000 years. So I tend to find wisdom and comfort and support in Luke's approach to this. Not so much it's going to happen today, but how do we live? Let it happen. I sat in Peru. And I heard, I would say something every now and then, but this was her time. It was her time to tell me about her, and I was enthralled. I was so caught up in what was happening in her life. I was so caught up with how she was dealing with her cancer. I was so caught up with how she was doing with her treatment, but mostly I was caught up with her. Paul. Said, do you know Dr. So-and-so? I said, sure, he was one of my seminary professors. Well, he's Episcopal now, but he wasn't always. Many, many years ago, back in our small town, he was our preacher. I knew him very well, and he found out I was here in the hospital, so he came the other day to visit. And as